Yeah. All right, so lock is last battery died. I was just reading it. Started from the top again, bro. I wanted this to come out right properly. But all praises to Yahweh Basham, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and the elders, a great millstone. But go ahead.
Psalms 99:1. Yahweh reigneth. Let the people tremble.
Yeah, these people, they supposed to be trembling. Right? Go ahead. Well, actually, the red light. Go through it. Read it again.
He said, Yahweh reigneth, let the people tremble. He sitteth between the cherubims, let the earth be moved.
Right, that cherubims, like that goes back, like we just said, this goes back to the so-called UFOs, right? And them crazy bugged out creatures the Lord's got in the angels. Because you're reading Ezekiel, the first chapter, that tells you about the cherubims and about the different crazy faces. You know what I'm saying? It goes into that in the book of Revelation. And that's going into the so-called UFOs, the UFOs too. Because that's the chariots of the Lord and the angels. So the so-called UFOs ain't aliens. That's the angels flying around. Oh, like I seen that video you reposted a video of the what was that, Israel satellite rocket or something?
Oh yeah,
it was about a launch. Yeah, it's a recent video floating around. And that just happened, didn't it? Yeah, it was launched. They was trying to launch a satellite in the outer space, and you could see a chariot, a so-called UFO, just zip by and blow it up.
Yeah, it was so weird because like before it blew up, like the middle of it disappeared or some shit, like the middle of the satellite.
It like went into another dimension or something.
Yeah.
That's pretty bugged out. Hey, but that's the Lord right there. And you can clearly see that was a cherry. That was not no man-made craft. And they got it on camera. So y'all can't say they don't exist. You know what I mean? But go ahead.
Yahweh is great in Zion, and he is high above all the people.
Yeah, the Lord is high above all the people, literally. Go ahead.
Let them praise thy great and terrible name.
So we're supposed to praise the great and terrible name of the Lord, which is Yahweh. And the son's name is Yahweh Shai, the one they ignorantly call Jesus. All right, so the father's name is Yahweh, and his name is very, very important. You can't just call God whatever you want. You can't, I'm going to call him Yahweh. One of us is going to call him Yahweh. The other one's going to call him Jehovah. There's only one name, and his name is Yahweh. All right? Go ahead.
For it is spoken, the king's strength also loveth judgment. Thou dost establish equality.
Equity.
Equity.
Which means righteous. Well, equity means equal, right? That's judgment. When you see the judgment depicted, like they had Lady Justice or whatever, she'll have scales, right? Because you want to make sure everything's equally balanced out. That's where that word equity goes back to the word equal, which means, you know, righteous judgment. Go ahead. Make sure everybody gets their fair shake. So what does scripture say about a false balance? A false balance is an abomination to the Most High. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Thou executest judgment and righteousness in Jacob.
In Jacob. Because that, once again, it tells you that the Lord is only dealing with the nation of Israel. The Lord did not come to save all the nations. The Lord chose a special people unto himself. And that's the nation of Israel. Go ahead. That's why you ain't going to see everybody out here rocking a Bible, teaching a Bible. The heathens ain't going to teach the Bible because the Bible was not given to a heathen. That's why you ain't never going to see him do what we do. Because this was only given to Jacob. The word is only given to Israel. And that's a fact. Go ahead.
Excel ye Yahweh our God, and worship at his footstool, for he is holy. Moses and Aaron among his priests, and Samuel among them that call upon his name.
They called upon his name, on his name. Right? He didn't just say call him whatever he wanted. They called on his name, which was Yahweh. Go ahead.
And he answered them.
And he answered them. He spoke to them. The Lord appeared before Moses. You know what I mean? The Lord went up. Moses spake to the Most High. He went up on top of Mount Sinai and up in the chariot talking to the Lord. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
back unto them in a cloudy pillar. They kept his testimonies in the ordinance that he gave them. Thou answered them, O Yahweh our God, thou wast a God that forgavest them, though thou tookest vengeance on their invention.
Right, even though the Lord, you know, jacked us up, destroyed us. Like you read in Ezekiel how the angel went through and was killing everybody, all the Israelites. Even though the Lord beat your ass at me, he still loves you, he still forgives you in the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? It's hard to focus out here.
Thanks. Worship at his holy hill, for Yahweh our God is holy.
Yep. The Most High is holy. He's the holiest of the holies. Hey, did you check his messages? See, did you tell him where the spot? Did you tell him when he's coming down here? Man, the traffic's bad though, so he probably got caught up in traffic. If you got any precepts, just go ahead and bring them out. I'm about to give a precept.
Psalms 4. It says, actually, yeah. Stand in awe and sin not. Commune with your own heart upon your bed and be still. It's a lot.
The point I was getting at because it says, stand in awe. The scripture that's read.
Yeah.
Said, you know, he's fearful, you know, fear, what's the praise, his fearful name. You know, he's saying fearful, you know, because you gotta stand in awe before him. Don't just come up, like niggas come up to camp talking shit.
Oh yeah, you ain't supposed to be scared of nothing. Only thing we afraid of is the Most High, and that's it.
Most of all, like, I was talking about, like, people, like, how they, like, they just rash with their mouth, they just call God whatever the fuck they want. Talk shit to the prophets of the Lord, and the scripture says he's above, you below.
Yeah, well, the reason everything's so fucked up out here, the reason the world's such a disgusting, filthy place to live, is nobody got to fear the Lord in. You know what I mean? Everybody feeling like they can do whatever they want. They can do it their way, you know what I mean? Like, I'm gonna do it my way. I believe what I want, how I want to believe it. You know what I mean? Instead of doing what they told. See, our people don't want to do what they told. The disobedient children. My fault, I can't even fucking hear what's going on. Hey, I'm gonna read this stuff. Man, my phone's messed up. I got a precept for the name. Hold on. You got some? I got some. I got a scripture though, the back, the movie's talking about how the name, you gotta call on the name, right? Psalms 83:18. That men may know that thou, whose name alone is Yahweh, art the Most High over all the earth. So it said the Lord got one name, his name alone is Yahweh. It didn't say he had multiple names, you know what I'm saying? I got another one too.
Deuteronomy 28:58. If thou wilt not observe to do all the words.
Is that ringing?
Yeah,
that's
probably different. If thou wilt not observe to do all the words of this law, thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name.
So you're supposed to fear the glorious and fearful name of the Lord, which is Yahweh. And his son's name is Yahweh Shai. Go ahead. Read that again all the way through.
Deuteronomy 28:58. If thou would not observe to do all the words of this law, thou art written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name of Yahweh thy God.
Yeah, you're supposed to observe all the things written in the law. I mean, don't eat pork. Don't be a faggot. Don't commit adultery. All right, simple moral principles. Hey, get a. Oh yeah, get your message. I'll bring the scripture up. That one him? Some douchebag, huh? Somebody trolling your page? And if you get a big ring like that, that should be annoying as hell.
Go for it. YouTube.
I'd have to turn off YouTube notifications, bro. They be blowing me up. You think you got an important message or something? There's some asshole scoffing on the comment board. Because, look, I get a lot of comments on our YouTube videos, right? A lot of comments. But I would say about... I'd say about 66.6% of the comments are just negative. But that's two-thirds of Israel, bro. They're always talking shit. There's always more negative comments than positive comments. Always people talking shit. You know, man, say if I make a video about the name of the Lord like we're doing right now, and I'll hit all these scriptures, and they just ignore every scripture we give them, you know what I mean? So it's like you gotta do the video again on a comment board with them. Like, bro, we just went over this in the video. Did you even watch it? Or are you just talking shit? You know what I mean? But look, I got this scripture. And I got a scripture too that proves you're supposed to call on the Lord's name and his son's name. And it tells you that in the Old Testament. Proverbs 30:4. Hey, we was just talking about the chariots too, right? Now watch this. Who hath ascended up into heaven or descended? What's that talking about, ascend to heaven and descend? That's talking about those so-called UFOs. The Lord flying around in the chariots. That's what that's talking about. Who else, you know, how did the Lord leave the earth? When you read the book of Acts, the first chapter, it tells you that the Lord, Yahweh Shah, he got received by a cloud, which was a chariot. He got beamed up like Scotty. All right, just like on Star Trek. He got beamed up. And it tells you that's how he left it. He ascended into heaven, right? Didn't that the Most High, when he come down to Mount Sinai, when you read Exodus the 19th chapter and Exodus the 20th chapter, and it tells you how the chariot of the Lord ascended and descended upon Mount Sinai with a great smoke and fire. And we can get into that, you know what I mean? But Proverbs 30:4, who ascended up into heaven or descended? Who hath gathered the wind in his fist? Who hath bound the waters in a garment? That's talking about outer space. Who hath established all the ends of the earth? What is his name and what is his son's name, if thou canst tell? So the scriptures is asking you a question about the name of the Lord. It says, what is the Most High's name? And not only what is his name, but what is his son's name, if you can tell? That's a very specific question, you know what I mean? So it must mean the answer is very important if the Lord was asking that question, you know what I mean? Because the Most High, look, it says, what is his name and what is his son's name, if thou can tell? And this is obviously talking about the Messiah in the Old Testament. Because people try to say, anybody who worships, follows the New Testament is an idol worship. There's only one God. You know, they'll say that. They don't understand the scriptures. They don't understand the ordinances and the way the Lord set up the order of the universe. You know what I'm saying? The Son of the Most High was mentioned all throughout the Old Testament. And in the scriptures ask you, said, what is the Most High's name and what is his son's name, if you can tell? You guys think I forgot about his loud ass book. So he never hit you back up?
He said he's on the way last time.
This traffic is so bad though, man. Go ahead.
It's 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear them from heaven and I will forgive their sin and I will heal their land.
Read that again. That's a good scripture.
I thought we put on.
That's still a great scripture. I have something to add to it.
If my people which are called by my name.
My people which are called by my name. Go ahead.
Shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. Then when I hear from heaven, I will forgive their sin.
Yeah, that's something. That's a that It said, if my people will humble themselves, turn away from their wickedness. You think the most of these people gonna do that? They're not gonna do that, bro. But he said, if they did, what would he do though?
Then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sin and will hear their land, heal them.
And heal the land, right. Right, because the Lord came to forgive your sins, man. So the average person, here it is, the Lord gives them the opportunity to repent. You know what I mean? But they pass it up, bro. And in their mind, they didn't do nothing wrong to begin with. You know what I mean? So the average person is wicked and selfish as hell, man. The average person is just a selfish pile of lies and filth. You know what I mean? When you think about it, you try to describe these people. It may just nothing, but the average person is full of nothing but lies and blasphemy and filth. Because then the scriptures say they've all become filthy. You know what that said? That's how Isaiah, right?
Yeah.
Although I got, let me get a report. And now Isaiah. I'm with you. Yeah, no, that's Psalms. Is that right? No, actually, I'm totally wrong. Well, that's Psalms 14 and 3. That's a famous one. I'll just read that one. What's the ones where the tables are full of vomit?
Yeah, it's like 20. It's talking about here a little, there a little.
Yeah.
It's like four.
Y'all go ahead.
Isaiah 12 and 4.
Shit.
In that day shall you say, praise Yahweh, call upon his name.
It said, praise Yahweh, call on his name. Right? So you're supposed to call upon the name of Yahweh. Not loud. Like your boy last week, we came out of here last week. This dude kept talking about God. God's name is not God. How stupid is that? Actually, God is an English word. It means good. You know, in German, good is a good, right? And God is God. God is, it's the same word. Just like the word, just like you got good and evil, okay? Good is God in the English language. And evil, or the devil, you got God and the devil, right? Well, the devil has the word evil in it. Just like the word God has. It's the same word. When you look at it. Because we speak in English, bro. We ain't speaking Hebrew. The Bible is written in Hebrew. The ancient Israelites spoke Hebrew. They didn't speak English. There was no word called God in their vocabulary. The closest thing to God was Gad, which means a troop. Yeah, a troop. Like the tribe of Gad. Look at these dumb motherfuckers, bro. GD in Hebrew is Gad, like the tribe of Gad. So there's no word God in the Bible, okay? God's name is Yahweh. Get it right. There's no word called Lord in the Bible. You got more than that?
Prayer's doings among the people make mention that his name is exalted.
Oh, it said, read that again.
To make mention that his name is exalted.
No, read all of it.
This is Isaiah 12 and 4. In that day shall you say, praise Yahweh, call upon his name. Declare his doings among the people.
Yeah, declare his doings among the people. So how do you do that? How do you declare his doings among the people? You gotta do this. Come out in the streets, teach. You put little videos up on the internet, on YouTube. Get your little Twitter account. Troll people with that. You know, you got Twitter?
No,
I used to. I mean, I don't really use Twitter like I used to, but I still do it. Because you only got like so many characters you can put up. But I mean, it's still all these different sites where you can use these to push the truth. You know what I mean? And you're supposed to do it continually, just not once a month. You're supposed to teach continually. You're supposed to keep doing this work until you either drop dead or the Lord delivers us up out of here. You know what I mean? You're supposed to supposed to do it until the very end. To the very, very end. Revelation 2:26, and he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations. So it said, whoever keeps the works of the Lord unto the end, okay, that's who the Lord's gonna give power over the nations. That's what you call the elect of Israel right there. Check it out. And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. As the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father. Oh yeah, so in the kingdom, we're going to rule all nations with a rod of iron. All heathens are going to get broke to pieces. It's going to be beautiful. It's going to be great. Like that, well, on the way up here, we see some gooks driving. Oh, it's such a bad racist word, gooks. We engage in hate speech. But we seen them goddamn gooks driving their car. And they did the most uncoordinated, most dangerous automobile maneuver I done seen in a long time. Trying to turn around in the middle of rush hour traffic. You know what I mean? They was literally started turning around, did a 180 in rush hour traffic trying to maneuver through traffic. Just like some heathens. It's only something a heathen would do. The heathens can't drive. They can't do nothing right, bro. I was watching Family Guy once, and they showed what happened. They had the Chinese NASCAR. Did you ever see that episode? And as soon as the race started, all the cars crashed into each other. That was a good one. Hey, that's the truth, though, man. There's nothing, what's up? There's nothing worse than a heathen. But we're going to rule all these heathen nations with a rod of iron, okay? Contrary to popular belief, the one they call Jesus, he didn't come to save all the nations. He came to save the nation of Israel, which is scattered among all the nations. And when there he goes. Oh, shit, I see how you rolling today.
Hey, y'all ain't see me waving to you? Trying my best to get your attention.
He out there styling today. Oh, yeah, get some pretzels, some water.
Man,
it's
a lot.
Just a little.
Y'all got some change, man? I need some meter. I ain't got much for the meter. I ain't got none.
Hell yeah. You better hurry up. You know how they be. Goddamn devils. Yeah, because they be waiting, boy. If you don't put no money in that meter, boy, they'll get you. A bunch of faggots. You know, there's a lot of heathens out here. There's a lot of Jakes out here, too. I bet a lot of these Jakes out here on campus are athletes. Either athletes or they're trying to get some pussy or they work out here. Oh, yeah, definitely. They make a lot of money out here. Yeah, everybody out here is high out their fucking mind, bro. I guarantee you, damn near every person is walking down the street with a bag of weed or a bottle of pills on them. You know what I mean? Especially these women. You know what's in their purses? You don't want to open up the purse. She's going to have a bottle of pills, a bag of weed, a dildo. Yeah, needles. She's going to have all that makeup. You don't want to look in them purses, bro. These people are filth, man. That's why we out here, like the scripture he just read, though. Where is that?
That you read? Was that in Chronicles?
He was in the Old Testament, wasn't he? Yeah, because, you know, we come out here just to tell people to repent from the sin. Because it's never too late, man. Just like when the Lord was being crucified on the cross, he had two people that was getting... Hey, you know where that's at? That he had the two people getting crucified with him. And they was both criminals. They both, you know, committed some horrible crimes. That's why they was getting put to death, right? But the one dude on the cross repented. And then the Lord said that he was being seen to be in the kingdom with him. You know what that says? the three dudes on the cross and said, on this day, you see the kingdom of heaven, something like that. So the Lord will forgive all manner of sin, bro. You could be a murderer. You could have done killed somebody. You could have had a couple bodies on you, and the Lord will forgive you. Huh?
What is that?
We're teaching the Bible.
Huh?
The Bible. The Holy Bible. The Bible. You don't believe in the Bible?
Say no more.
Come here. Come here. He all right. He had a wicked spirit on him.
Oh, evil spirit. You see it, couldn't
he? He had that, that Santa de Muerto spirit. He probably want to kill us. He had the evil, evil spirit. You know where that's at? It's in John, eh? When he went into the crucifixion. The digital Bible looking for the tape. Always, you know, get them all mixed up. And that's the thing about the Bible, though, is like we have multiple accounts of the same story, like Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. That's not all the same book. These are all written by different authors. You know what I'm saying? And then it was all later compiled into one book called the Bible. Because there's, I was watching some documentaries on the Bible and the scriptures. You know there. Of all the ancient writings that were preserved, there are more. Most of this shit was about. There's more biblical writings preserved than any other writings from the ancient world. Why is that? Why did they want to preserve this so badly? I think they said 30 copies of Homer's Iliad and the Odyssey survived. Like 30 copies. But they got hundreds and hundreds of copies and thousands of copies of the Bible. Survive from the ancient world. One day he's on the cross, and when the Lord forgave the dude on the cross, you know what book that says?
Yeah. Because one of the brothers that was on the cross got condemned, and the other one said, "Most High, you know, you're gonna be in the kingdom with me." So one of the dudes on the cross knew he was a righteous man. So
you sure that's not John? Maybe it's a Luke. Hey, bro.
Here you go. Well, this is Matthew 27 and 36. And sitting down, they watched him there and set over his head this accusation written, "This is Yahweh Shai, the King of the Jews." Then were there two thieves crucified with him, one on the right hand and another on the left. And they that passed by reviled him, wagging their heads, and saying, "Thou that destroys the temple and buildest it in 3 days, save thyself. If thou be the Son of the Most High, come down from the cross." Likewise also the chief priests and the scribes and elders said, "He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the King of Israel, let him now come down from the cross, and we will believe him."
Yeah, because, no. They was mocking the Lord when he's on the cross, talking shit. So they thought it was funny. Go ahead.
I don't think it's in
Luke. No, it's not, but we're going to read that anyway. I think it's in Luke.
Right.
Either in Luke or John.
It's in here somewhere.
But read the rest of that, because that goes into what happened after he died.
Right.
And that's pretty crazy.
Yeah, some sci-fi.
Yeah.
He trusts in the Most High. Let him deliver him now, if he will have him, for he said, "I am the Son of the Most High." The thieves also, which were crucified with him, cast the same in his teeth. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. I thought it was in Matthew's though, but
yeah.
I guess it's not. And about the ninth hour, Yahushua cried with a loud voice, saying it, Eli, Eli, Lama, Sabathani.
It is Luke.
Is it Luke?
I want to hear the rest of that, though.
Okay. That is to say, my power, why hast thou forsaken me? Some of them that stood there when they heard that said, this man calleth for a life. And straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and put it in the reed and gave it to drink. That's some even shit right there, man. You ever taste some vinegar, just raw vinegar?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that's some bad shit, man. The rest said, let us see whether Elias will come to save him. You might want to keep that in mind. Get home, just to get a chance to get some vinegar. You know, so you can relate. Don't drink it. Just take a taste of it. Just taste it. You see why it's some fucked up shit to do. The rest said, let us.
He's probably thirsty as hell.
Yeah. Whether Elias will come to save him. And how was I when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the spirit? And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain.
The veil in the temple is this big, gigantic curtain, right? I mean, this thing is huge. It's like heavy as fuck. Like gigantic. It's like super, like impossible to rip in half, pretty much. But that shit ripped right in half.
Yeah, it was built nice.
Yeah.
It was some expensive shit.
It just got destroyed.
Right.
Go ahead.
It will remind you of a horror movie or some ghost movie when shit just start moving and tearing and shit.
It's like on the Ghostbusters. Well, it's way more...
Poltergeist.
Yeah, you know when the fucking dimensional portal opens and shit start shaking, buildings start collapsing?
Right.
That's why... Actually, where do you think a lot of these movies, they got all that from the script? All that stuff comes from the script. Go ahead.
And behold, the veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom, and the earth did quake and the rocks rent. And the graves were opened.
Yeah, and then listen to this. This is after the Lord was crucified. It said the graves were opened. Go ahead.
And the graves were opened, and many bodies of the saints which slept arose.
Many bodies of the saints that slept arose. Hey, this is something they don't teach you on Sunday.
They're saying they were asleep in bed or, you know.
Nah, bro. It means what it says.
Right, exactly.
Why do you think time itself is based on the Bible? Like, it's the year 2016.
I don't miss these heathens whatsoever, man.
It's weird out here, ain't it?
Yeah.
Different spirit, though.
And came out of the graves after his resurrection and went into the holy city and appeared unto many.
Appeared unto many. So why do you think that from the angel, why do you think that so many people wrote about this and you keep talking about the Bible? Because they remember that day when that happened. Could you imagine living in that time period 2,000 years ago in the first century? And that was still fresh in people's minds back then, and they knew what happened. It's like, oh my God.
Oh, check it out, bro. You have children after witnessing that. You're going to tell your children.
You're going to tell them.
And it's going to pass on.
And that's why they wrote it.
Yeah.
And that's why I said that there's four different accounts, you know, of the Lord's teachings in the Bible. It's not just one book. It's like multiple books, multiple witnesses and testimonies. And check this out. Like they said, there's more written about the one they call Jesus than any other person that ever lived. You know what I mean? That's a fact. Go ahead.
Now when the centurion and they that were with him watching the outside saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, saying, truly, this was the Son of the Most High.
Yeah, because at first they didn't know. They was just doing their job. But after they seen that, they could have been a Jake too. Only a Jake would probably admit to that. You know what I mean? He said, truly, this is the Son of God.
Yeah, he's going to get all the motherfuckers that was here, too.
Yep, he's going to get them. Hey, I got the scripture.
Right. The motherfuckers going to get it, man. If they ain't already getting it spiritually, you know, mentally. That's how I'm going to be playing, man. Many women were there, beholding afar off, which followed Yahushua from Galilee, ministering unto him, among which was Mary Magdalene, and Mary, the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of Zebedee's children. Keep going.
I got a precept for you. Is that 1:14 just real quick?
What's up? Genesis 2:15? It's in Genesis 2:15. Not fucking with y'all. I heard about y'all.
Who the hell?
I heard about y'all.
He just held up traffic for that too.
Right. You ever notice, man, sometimes people say shit and hop up behind me, like when we downtown, they behind a bus stop and go, yeah. You know, it's like an aura. We have that aura around us, man. We are men to fear, you know?
I got
men to fear, man.
I got a
You heard him, you see him say, uh-uh.
Yeah. He's like, uh-uh. He's scared, bro. How you gonna sit there and try to yell scriptures at us from a car?
Don't make sense. Genesis 2:15, doing like what?
What's it? Man, he created man and dressed him. Like, we know that, bro. We know about the creation story, bro.
Let that grow. You know?
The booty injector.
Titties will grow, booty, everything will grow to your desire.
Right.
You know, we all gonna be perfect artists in the kingdom, man. We all gonna be perfect artists, man. This day, you gotta luck up and gotta have big money to get what you want, man. You know?
That's all it's
and
all
even
about.
Then, when you get it, it's fucked up and polluted.
It's not as good as you thought it was gonna be.
Right. It's curse.
It's very disappointing.
It's a curse.
Yeah, it's like a lot of times, because you get all, a lot of brothers, they get all bent and shaped by these women. But a lot of times, say you lusting after a woman, but when you finally get with her, you let down almost every time. It's like the idea of it is better than the thing itself. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I had this beautiful bitch, man. She was bad, had body and everything until her clothes came off and the stomach. She always wore a thing that tightened it up.
Oh, man.
You know, she always wore something that tightened it up.
Held it in there.
Yeah. And she took it off every... The most disgusting shit ever seen.
I got a precept though. He was talking about how the Lord's gonna get every last one of the Romans that actually physically crucified him, right?
Right.
But this is Revelation 1:7. Behold, he cometh with clouds, which are those chariots, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him.
Right.
Even so, amen. Hold up. Didn't it just say, should it not say, that all kindreds of the earth shall be loved because of him? That's not what it says. We must have defective Bibles.
Right.
The pastor didn't tell me that.
Hey, I got another one.
Go ahead.
This is Hebrews 10:20, 10:30. For we know him that hath said, vengeance belongeth unto me. I will recompense, saith the Lord, and again the Lord shall judge his people.
That's a good one. The Lord, you're going to get recompense, bro. And recompense is payback.
Hey, y'all interpreting that wrong. That's your interpretation. Y'all using your
heart. So let's see y'all interpret those missiles. Oh. You seen that story I posted today on the Putin? Today's say Putin's, Russia's ready to shoot missiles over that thing in Syria.
Yeah, there's a lot of hot shit going on up there. They run it. You know, when war breaks out, there's drills running.
Yep.
Nations are running drills, and Russia is running a drill with the whole nation going into bunkers.
Man. Oh, yeah. They getting ready for nuclear war here. Everybody here is getting ready for what? Getting ready for that party Saturday night.
Right.
They getting ready for the Buckeyes game. That's what they ready for. Yeah. Get
it's
ready
gonna
for
the time when them drills will be taking place, and that's when it's gonna pop. That's gonna be it.
Here it is, nuclear war about to break out, and they worried about war with Michigan. You know what I mean?
She's looking to be the host of the orgy this weekend.
You already know that.
Right. With all the cocaine and weed and crystal meth and Percocets.
She ain't got a clue. She definitely don't have a clue about what's going on in the world.
Just told it. Yo, man. Hey, man, you know World War III about to pop off?
Really?
He don't care. You know the sodomite don't care.
That dude's fucking gay as hell.
Right.
He's a faggot, man. Who the fuck want to walk around looking like a faggot, bro? I mean, really, you actually like looking like that, bro?
Jake love that shit.
What the fuck is wrong with you people? Shit ain't cool, bro.
Y'all see the pictures of the protests at City Hall, man?
I was watching the live feed.
You see,
I should have hit you. It's hard for me to send links on the phone. They don't never work.
You see the dude, the preacher in the red shining suit?
Yeah.
The motherfucker was glittering and everything. He was shining, man. A bright red suit.
And all them Edomites out there protesting with him?
That's crazy, man. That's fucking crazy.
They always out there pretending that, like, they love Jake. Jake falls for that shit. Just like that Edomite woman we saw signing people up to vote at the bus stop. You know what I mean? And she's out there hugging people, high-fiving.
Yeah, right.
When we talk to her, she ignores us. Hey, let's get back to that crucifixion story. You want me to read it? I got it. Luke 22. Luke 23, I mean. Or did you want to read it? Where are you at? I don't know where to start. Hey, you want to read it? Or I can read it. It don't matter.
It's Luke, about the two
Yeah, Luke 23. So I don't know where to start, though. It's all good. I say we can just start at 32. 23 and 32. That's what a lot of people don't get. You know what I mean?
I was looking for something else. That goes with that.
Yeah, 32 and yeah.
This is Luke 23 and 32. It says, and there were also two other.
Right, this is still talking about the crucifixion. So the Lord's up there on the cross, right? But there's two other people getting crucified with him at the same time. Go ahead.
Malefactors led.
And malefactor, like the word malefactor has the word malin, and mal means bad. That's where you get the word malice. You know what I mean? It's like the opposite of the word malefactor is a benefactor. Benefactor means benefit. I know a lot of y'all, brothers, you know, I always used to be retarded too, so we gotta go over words. You know what I mean? A lot of young brothers don't know what words mean. That's why benefactor means what? Like the word benefit.
Well,
what's up, bro?
What's up, fellas?
Go ahead.
So he's just.
Hey, what's up, fellas?
Just
one of the guys. Go ahead.
They put him to be put to death. And when they were come to the place which is called Calvary, that they crucified him with malefactors, one on the right hand, one on the other, and the other on the left. Then said Yahweh Shai, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Right, he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And really, that's a lot of these people out here, bro. A lot of these people, they don't know what the hell they're doing. They eating pork. They've never been told that was wrong before. You know what I mean? They celebrate Christmas. I mean, they've never been told that was wrong. They doing all this wicked shit, but they don't think it's wrong. They think it's okay. They think it's okay to have sex with a woman who's not a virgin. They've never been taught otherwise. They've been taught that marriage is when you go to court and, you know, someone puts a ring on your finger. They don't know no better. Go ahead.
See why you want to. That's just distracting as a
motherfucker. It is very distracting, bro.
So we ain't faggots.
I already seen one. I already claimed way back where. My girl earlier, bro.
This is ridiculous, man. It's ridiculous.
There's so many women out here, bro. It's crazy. Go ahead. The Lord gonna give us this, bro. Go ahead.
And it departed his remnant and cast lots. And the people stood beholding. And the rulers also with them declared, you're right. Rid it, you know what I'm saying? He saved others, let him save himself. For if he be the Christ, the chosen of God, then the soldiers also mocked him, coming to him and offering him vinegar, and saying, if thou be the King of the Jews, save thyself. And of a superscription also was written.
Subscription. Well, yeah, superscription. I mean, Pilate wrote on his thing. Go ahead.
Also was written over him in and letters of Greek and Latin. The Hebrew, this is the king of the Jews.
Yeah, right. So when that tells you, you had Jakes that spoke all those different languages. Because, plus, you know, a lot of Jakes was trilingual back in those days. Spoke all the languages.
That's more common, too.
Yeah. Well, you had to know Greek to do business. That was where the main language of commerce was Greek. Then all the Israelites knew the scriptures, so they had to read Hebrew. Plus, you had the Latin and the centurions and the legions was over there, so you had to have people to read Latin. Because Pilate spoke probably Latin. You know what I mean? He probably spoke all three languages too, though. So go ahead.
One of the malefactors which were hanged riled on him, saying, "If thou be Christ, save thyself and us also."
Yeah, so this one dude was up there talking shit, bro. Here it is, he's getting crucified with him. He's talking shit, running his mouth. Go ahead. But the other guy that was also being crucified, he rebuked the other guy that was talking shit, bro. The spirit jumped on him. Go ahead.
"Does not thou fear the Most High, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? And we indeed justified, for we received the due reward of our deeds, but this man hath done nothing amiss."
Ooh, that's powerful. Because he admitted his guilt right there. You know what I mean? So he's like, I know damn well what you did was fucked up. But you ain't gonna talk shit about this man. He did nothing wrong. You know what I mean? Talking about the Lord. Go ahead.
"And he said unto Hoshai, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom."
So that's where he showed his faith and he believed on the Lord. Go ahead.
"And Hoshai said unto him, Verily I saw, he's like, Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise."
Shall be with me in paradise. But that right there, the Lord forgave him all of his sins right then and there on the spot. Hey, your boy didn't even go out and teach you nothing. He was on the cross. He's about to get put to death. But that's all. That's what it takes to get saved, though. You gotta believe, bro. You gotta show faith.
Even Pilate's wicked ass knew the man was innocent.
Yeah. Pilate said, but he was afraid of the Jews. So Pilate feared man more than God. Because he's right, he's a heathen, he's an Edomite. Yep. Hey, that's just like that scripture one where then Pilate asked him a question. He said, "What is truth?" You remember that? Well, you know that's a John, right? He said, "What is truth?"
First John 1.
It really is. Yeah. You can see when the demons jump in somebody. He over there spitting now.
1 John 1:6-5. "This then is the message which we have heard of him and declared to you, that the Most High is light with him with no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and not the truth. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Yahushua, the Son, cleanses us from all sin."
Right, the Lord's blood right there. Because the Lord, he set himself up as the ultimate offering for Israel's sin. That's why they call him the Lamb. You know what I'm saying? Because the symbolism going back to the sacrifice of a lamb that you offer up for your sins. Go ahead.
"If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves."
Right. Oh, I'm sorry, read that again.
"If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us."
Yeah, because you got a lot of people, they try to act like they're holier than you and better than you, but like, "I don't sin, I ain't never broke no laws and nothing." You know what I mean? People is crazy. Like your boy IUIC Nate. When you look at all the dudes in this camp, bro, they got carvings in their hair, faded up. You know what I mean? They just breaking all kind of laws just by looking at them. You could just look at all the laws they done broke. I bet them little flashy garments they got, those aren't made of all the same material. They just some hypocrites, man.
I guarantee you before that camera turned on, they all go to the barbershop.
Yeah, because they be looking all pretty and shit.
They were clean.
They clean cut, all edged up and everything. Remember one time my sons came home from the from my from their baby's mom's weekend one time. They came home with an edge up, bro. I was ready to beat that bitch's ass. That shit just all lined up and shit. You know what I mean?
First thing you do is say something to her, cause she gonna do it again once you say something to her.
Yep. Nah, I cursed her out. I said, bitch, she not. You got more of that?
He said, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. To cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Yeah, say, yeah, that's what we pray in the Lord, cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Go ahead.
We say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar.
Matter of fact, I know what I've sinned and I know what I've done wrong. You know what I mean? A lot of people, that is not even their mom. You know what I mean? Or the average asshole out here, they don't even know what a sin is. I mean, what is a sin?
Right.
First, you gotta know, and we ain't went over that in a minute, bro. Get that John 3 and 4. 1 John 3 and 4. Because first you gotta know what a sin is. That's so basic, I be forgetting to talk about it, you know what I mean? There's a lot of people still don't know.
I'm gonna start at one. I'm gonna start at the top. Because the point is,
yeah, it's all fire.
Right. 1 John 3 and 1. Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of the Most High.
Ha! The sons of God, right? The sons of the Most High. Hey, not the Nephilim.
Yeah.
You read about the sons of God and what? In Genesis 6, right? That's talking about us. Not no fallen angels, bro. Go ahead.
Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, now are we the sons of the Most High, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him.
Oh, we shall be like him. Because, oh, just like Paul said, we're going to be changed in the twinkling of an eye. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to get those spiritual powers. Go ahead. And he's going to perfect us. He's going to put in our spirit that we'll never sin again. We're going to be perfect.
Reprogrammed.
Right now, we're pretty much like pieces of shit, right? Just begging for forgiveness. I mean, pretty much. But in the kingdom, we're going to be made perfect. Go ahead.
For we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure.
Right, you purify, even though we done committed all kind of sin, and we still sin, we can't help it, right? But just by you acknowledging that you're doing wrong and being wicked, and you trying your best not to do it, bro, and that's how you become holy, or what do you call it? Like that scripture said, what did it say, you purify? Yeah, because every day, right, you're supposed to kill that old man. Every day you're supposed to be like it should be like, you should become a new man every day, actually. Every day you're supposed to get better and better, not get worse.
Even like on the Sabbath, man, I was taking out the trash, man. I forgot I was, you know, going to work. I was sweeping. It just caught me. It just fucked me up, man.
Oh,
like shit, man.
Now that's going to be on the comment, bro. Oh, clickety clack, clackety click. The Lord's going to destroy you. You right. Testify with your own mouth that you worked on the Sabbath. Dad, he's about to run them hoes over.
For you right there. Yeah. That's an asshole. Man.
Yeah,
Four, whoso committeth, start back at three, and every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure. Whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law.
Right, because sin is the transgression of the law. What law? It's not just any law you think. It's not the Constitution. It's not America's laws. It's the laws of the Bible in the Old Testament. The laws in the Old Testament that said what? Don't kill, don't steal, don't be a faggot, don't commit adultery, don't eat pork. That's a big one though, eating swine's flesh. It's the biggest one. That's the one our people do not want to give up.
Pork and adultery doing
it. Because there's dietary laws you're supposed to be following. You're not supposed to eat no shrimp. The Bible says anything that comes out the water, the only thing you're allowed to eat out of the water is fishes that have what, scales and fins. So that no catfish, no lobster.
Just fucking move.
Yeah, not anything that move. They like to eat all the creepy crawlers, bro.
Worst shit.
The women, they think that the lobster is something you eat at a fine dining restaurant. No, that's something that you eat on like a movie called, like an assault movie. You know, where they all kind of make you do sick, twisted shit. That's like something you would torture somebody with. I'm gonna force you to eat this. You know what I mean? It's got antennae. Dang, it look like that little pincher. It looks like an alien, bro.
Scale on the outside, like a roach.
Yeah, it's like a roach.
A roach guy, it's armor, it's, you know, it's, it will hold it together, it's on the outside.
Who looks at that and be like, that looks tasty.
Right.
No, it looks fucking scary.
Hey, then they tax them for the shit.
Yeah, it's expensive.
Yeah.
And I was actually reading an article, and they said lobster used to be the type of foods they used to feed as slaves.
That's crazy.
We could look at, you can Google that, see what pops up.
Niggas ate it up. Whosoever abideth in him sinneth not. Whosoever sinneth have not seen him.
Did you see that? Read that again, though. That's deep. He said he that abideth in him sinneth not.
I missed the whole verse. And ye know that he was manifested to take away our sins, and in him is no sin.
In him is no. The Lord is perfect, all right?
Whosoever abideth in him sinneth not.
Whoever abideth in him sinneth not, all right?
Whosoever sinneth have not seen him, neither known him.
Yeah. So, that's what most people, everybody living in sin. And they do it willfully, you know what I mean? Go ahead.
Yeah, this is some meat too, man.
Especially, like, look at all the faggots and shit you see walking around. All these sodomites. We seen a big 6'8" tranny walking by earlier, bro. Big.
That was a sight to see.
It was scary.
Right. Hang on, dog. Little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committeth sin is of the devil.
He that commits the sin is the devil.
For the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of the Most High was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil.
Yeah, so, right. So the Son of... So Yahweh Shai, his whole purpose is to destroy the works of the devil. And why do you think they crucified him? Because they're a bunch of damn devils. You know what I mean? Because even the high priest Caiaphas, hey, you know, what's that scripture? I think it's John 16. What's it, 16? Not 16. It might be 16. All right, somewhere. When even Caiaphas, the high priest of Israel, knew that Yahweh Shai was the son of the Most High and the Messiah. But he feared man more than the Most High. You see what I'm saying? Because he feared the Romans. He feared Esau more than he feared the Lord. You know where that's at? Is it John 16? That's the prayer, though, I think, of John 16. Where's in the garden? Or is that 17?
I'm going to read this while you're getting that. This is St. John 8:44. Ye are of your father, the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do.
Yeah, this is what the Lord was saying to those wicked-ass Israelites.
He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh his own, for he is a liar and the father of it.
Yeah, because you know, people always come out here, and what they always say, I want to hear what you think and what you feel. You know, because when these people come out here with their knowledge, they speak of their self and their own spirit. They ain't coming in the spirit of the Lord. When all these scoffers come up here, that's how you can tell who's coming in the spirit of Satan, bro. When they start talking about, oh, I got my own words. Go ahead.
And because I tell you the truth, ye believe me not. Which of you convinceth me of sin? And if I say the truth, why do ye not believe me? Like you were saying, shit you ain't supposed to. There's laws in the Bible.
There's laws, right. Yeah. It's black and white. It's like crystal clear. It says clear as day, well, in Leviticus 11, not to eat swine. It says don't eat catfish. Don't eat shellfish. Don't eat goddamn clams. Don't eat oysters. Who in their right mind would eat a fucking oyster, bro?
Ugh,
slimy oysters, ass shit. Right, that's right. The scripture says.
It's never cooked like to the point like, damn.
And you watch them when they eat them, they're all
fucking fucking oyster. They like them raw though.
That's nasty.
A fucking oyster.
Fucking heathen like oyster. Shit. That's only something a heathen would do, bro.
This is the point. This is the meat right here. 47. Let me start back at 46. Which of you convinces me of sin? And if I say the truth, why do you not believe me? He that is of the Most High heareth the Most High's words.
Yeah, he that is of the Most High, you hear these words. These words, they gonna mess with your spirit. You're like, oh, that's that real right there. That's right. That's 100. How do they talk? Yeah, y'all keep it 100. Right, yeah. Y'all keep it 100 though. You know how they be talking.
Ye therefore hear them not, because ye are not of the Most High.
Right. Because, yeah, that's exactly. So if somebody doesn't agree with this, it's not because they have a different opinion. No, it's because they're the devil. That's why. Well, we gotta respect each other's opinions. You know how they be.
Yeah.
Hey, fuck your opinion, bro. Where in the scriptures does it say respect opinions?
All right.
I've never seen that scripture. Yep, I got a scripture for that Uncle Tom. What you got? Go ahead. Bring it out. No, go ahead.
First John.
Yeah, Caiaphas.
Oh. It's 1 John 4:3. Every spirit that confesses not. Every spirit that confesses not that Yahweh Shai is coming to flesh is not of God. And this is the spirit of Antichrist. Therefore ye have heard that it shall come, and even now already in the world. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. They are of the world, therefore speak they of the world, and the world heareth them. We are of God, he that knoweth God heareth us, he that is not of the Most High hear not us, thereby know we the spirit of truth and the spirit of error.
Right, we see that a lot too. We'll be up here teaching, and then a group of people will come up, right, and some scoffer will come out saying, y'all's full of shit, you don't know the Bible. And then another scoffer will come up, then all the scoffers will all join forces together because they only can understand the words of the world, okay, because their spirit is of the world, their spirit's not of the Father.
Right.
So that's why they always going to gang up on us, you know.
Like a motherfucker that says, give me a quick message or whatever. That's
yeah.
A motherfucker ain't, you know, he ain't hear the words.
He wants to hear the words of the world.
Hear something quick. That's a motherfucker just picking and choosing.
Because if we came out here, if we was out here like freestyling, had the microphone and all that, he would drop a nice beat. We start just getting it in with the freestyle. People become, oh, what's up, bro? Let me get your number. What's your Facebook? Yeah, though. For we gonna kick it though. Yeah, you my brother though.
It's a water with sandwiches.
Yeah. Oh, we pass out sandwiches. Oh, we definitely get some fans. Get some thumbs ups. You know what I mean? But if you gonna come out here and teach the truth. If you teach the words of the Heavenly Father, hey, people ain't gonna accept you. Because these people, they part of the world, bro.
That has what? To be a tear.
Looking like, what's your boy off of The Simpsons?
Like a bootleg Lenny Kravitz.
Look like Slideshow Bob.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That dude with the fur.
Yeah. Hey, I want to get this thing about Caiaphas, unless you got something. Right, this is John 18 and 12. Then the band and the captains and the officers of the Jews took Yahweh Shai and bound him and led him away to Annas first, for he was father-in-law to Caiaphas, which was the high priest that same year. Now Caiaphas was he which gave counsel to the Jews that it was expedient that one man should die for the people. So he wanted to kill the Lord. And Simon Peter followed Yahweh Shai, and so did another disciple. That disciple was known unto the high priest and went in with Yahweh Shai into the palace of the high priest. But Peter stood at the door without, then went out that other disciple, which was known unto the high priest, and spake unto her that kept the door and brought in Peter. Then saith the damsel that kept the door unto Peter, art not thou also one of his man's disciples? He said, I am not. And the servants and the officers stood there, who made a cold fire of coals, for it was cold. They warmed themselves, and Peter stood with them and warmed himself. I think I skipped the point I was actually looking for. Actually, I'm just going to keep going, because this is fire. John, I just messed it up, but oh well. John, was this 18 and 19? The high priest then asked Yahawashi of his disciples and of his doctrine. Yahawashi answered him, I spake openly to the world. I ever taught in the synagogue and in the temple where the Jews always resort, and in secret have I said nothing. Oh, he said in secret. That's a good scripture for them Freemasons. Like, we was up in that Freemason temple the other day when they got all the windows boarded up and they do everything in secret. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was some bugged out shit.
That was bugged out.
That was some bugged out shit. So we went there on the building.
So we don't do nothing. So everything we do is open. This is as open as you get right here, bro. You come outside teaching like this, you don't get no more open than this. Ain't nothing secret. Hey, these words are still secret. You know we teach them openly. Like, they got ears, but they can't hear. Just like the scriptures say. Said, why askest thou me? Ask them which heard me, what I have said unto them. Behold, they know what I said. I mean, that's the point. I'm gonna skip down here. You got something you wanna bring out? I got, since we're reading the same story, I can keep going right here real quick. John, what is it, 18 and 34. Yeah, how was I, I'm gonna start at 33. Then Pilate entered into the judgment hall again and called Yahawashi and said unto him, art thou the king of the Jews? Yahawashi answered him, sayest thou this thing of thyself, or did others tell it thee of me? Pilate answered, am I a Jew? Thine own nation and the chief priests have delivered thee unto me. What hast thou done? Yahawashi answered, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servants fight, that I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now is my kingdom not from hence. Pilate therefore said unto him, art thou a king then? Yahawashi answered, thou sayest that I am a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause came I into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth. Everyone that is of the truth heareth my voice. And that goes with that Johnny red. Because remember, it said, damn, battery just died.